Hello, tune you back again. This is game number 6 of my 12 Games of Christmas. This is on the Wii U. This is Shovel Knight. This is a fantastic... I know it came out a few years ago, but it is a fantastic platform game that I did review a little while ago, and I gave 9.5. Last Christmas, I had this as a Christmas present, and I loved it and played it all over Christmas, and it was brilliant. I would say it was a little bit, when I had seen reviews of everyone saying this game is amazing, I was a little bit dubious, I suppose, to whether it was that good, but when I played it, it is an amazing game. It is proper, don't do New Game Plus. It's a proper old school platform game. Basically, what you've got here is, you've got Shovel Knight, who basically is a knight with a shovel. It's very sort of, how can I say this, very Mega Man-ish, I suppose, in some ways, and it's just got everything an old school platform game would have. You jump through the levels, you basically use your shovel to kill things. It is just a fantastic game. So let's do the first level. I'm playing this on the Wii U, but this game came out on practically all the new consoles. You can get it on, you can get the PlayStation and everything, and I would suggest if you're going to pick it up, is, you know, get this game, because it is awesome. So the idea is, you go for the levels, you can hit things with your shovel and kill them, and you can pull down and you can bash things with your shovel. Oh, I haven't got my power up now. And basically, you work your way through the levels, you fight bosses. It's just a really cool level. That sparkling thing down there, basically you can go fishing and you can find things down there. But there's lots of secrets to this game. There's loads of secrets through the levels. You usually find them in the walls, like there's one up there to the wall on the left. Ah. And they usually get treasured, or you get health refills. And basically, you fight your way through the game, various levels, various bosses, pretty much like a proper old school platform game. It is just a really cool game. And all the praise that this game actually gets, it deserves it all, I think. It's got clever bosses. There's some amazing speedruns of this, if you look around the net. There's lots of people doing speedruns of this. Good thing about this as well is they released free DLC called Plague Knight. So you use one of the bosses, which is the Plague Knight boss. And you can use this to get up there, and basically using Plague Knight, this game is completely different. So it's almost like getting two games in one. I say I was a little bit, I couldn't quite decide what I wanted to show you. I was going to go for the Mighty Switch Force, which is an amazing game as well, and that would have been a damn good pick for games to play over Christmas as well. But I think I'll go with this. These things are secrets, so if you put yourself in the right position and push up, you get to lots of secret levels. This guy gives you like different magic abilities. So I got the one here, makes me go invisible, so you're basically invulnerable for a couple seconds. Very handy, that is, actually. Especially for a lot of the bosses. I knew that was going to happen. Timed that well off end, didn't I? What happens when you die as well, you get back to these respawn points and you can go back and get your money, but what you can also do is smash these respawn points, which will give you a lot of gold and diamonds, but you won't be able to respawn there anymore. I don't really want to go down there, do I? I want to go over here. So you can go back to your gold there, so I can basically go and retrieve my gold. You can also get different armors in the same which do slightly different things. So this game also has a really fantastic soundtrack by Vert or Jake Coughlin, as his name is. His soundtracks are pretty amazing, by the way, so if you ever get a chance to have a listen to some of his soundtracks, try him out, because they're very good, really catchy tunes. He's quite a talented guy. Ah, I didn't get up here. There's lots of secrets. There's another secret up there. And there's one in the wall there. So I say, like, yeah, you know, this is the Wii U version, but you can get this game on lots of other platforms. And if you don't have a Wii U, I definitely suggest picking this game up. It's got some very cunning platform as well. Ooh. Again, then. You can't get over there without getting it. Will I get to the boss? Yeah, here we go. There is like super fast ways of killing these bosses as well. Picture of this. That's it, he's dead. Go see how they speed run, how fast they kill these bosses. It's pretty cool. So there's lots of little items you get in here which open up even more secrets. There's lots of different powers and stuff that Shovel Knight can get. There's loads of levels, there's towns to visit. I say this is the size of the map basically, and each one of those square blocks is a level or something, and it basically goes right the way across. Lots of towns to visit and stuff. So where should we go back here? I tell you what, I'll go back out. Let's return to the title screen. I'll see if I can show you Plague Knight. If I start the game, I haven't done much with Plague Knight because the game is vastly different to what it was before. It's mad how different the game is. So Plague Knight is one of the bosses. So basically I haven't got my sword anymore, I got these bombs, and there's like various jumps and stuff you can do like that. The game is so much different playing these. You can do boost jumping by holding down the fire button. Gotta get the hang of doing that. You need that boost jumping to go all over the place, like. Like I said, as I mentioned before, music in this game is fantastic. I say, such a different game when you actually get Plague Knight. There's a secret up there, but I won't go for it. You can boost past him.
That's a secret, but I won't go into there. You can also get different power-ups with Plague Knight as well. I do love the music on this game. Alright, I'll show you a little bit more of this game and then we call it quits. It's mad how much of a different game this is when using Plague Knight. There's also another secret over there as well. These bits are quite clever. You've got to tempt this guy on it, he's really heavy. Oh, got to stuff me then. You get those coins, you can buy items with them. Right. That's it, need to do that. This bit's quite tricky. I just want to carry on playing this game now. But anyway guys, that is Shovel Knight on the Wii U. Like I said, this you can pick this game up in almost everything. It came out on everything. It's a downloadable game, but they did do, it's out on PC as well, but they did do a physical release, which is what I've got by here. And the physical release comes with the Plague Knight add-on, which is free by the way, which is pretty cool. The company checked it out free. Also, from what I've heard, they've got another new episode and DLC coming out for this game free next year as well. So that'll be interesting. I'll be interested to see what they do with this game. It's cool that they are, you know, giving you a lot of stuff free and they're still supporting it. But yeah, Shovel Knight. I had it last year myself for Christmas and I couldn't stop playing it. I went all the way through and I loved every minute of it. It was awesome. So if you can, guys, pick yourself up Shovel Knight on the Wii U or pick it up on anything else you can, because if you like old school platform games, this is a real gem. Anyway, guys, I'll catch you tomorrow now with game number 7. So bye now.